Eco-terrorist release King Ghidorah, who awakens other monsters known as Titans across the world, forcing Godzilla and Mothra to surface and engage Ghidorah and Rodan in a decisive battle. When I first watched Godzilla, King of the Monsters, directed by Michael Dougherty, I wasn't just diving into another monster flick, I was stepping into the third entry of the Monsterverse and the 35th film in the legendary Godzilla franchise. This film, being a sequel to the 2014 Godzilla and the third Godzilla film to be completely produced by a Hollywood studio, carried the weight of many expectations. Despite its mixed reception, I found myself both intrigued and impressed by its unique handling of the monster genre. One of the standout aspects of Godzilla King of the Monsters is its visual prowess. The film delivers breathtaking CGI shots that bring the colossal titans to life in a way that is nothing short of spectacular. From Godzilla's imposing presence to the ethereal beauty of Mothra, the visual effects are a feast for the eyes. However, in an era where high-quality CGI is increasingly common, these visuals, while impressive, don't necessarily break new ground. Despite this, the film's commitment to creating a visually captivating experience is commendable. What truly sets Godzilla King of the Monsters apart is its narrative depth. Unlike any monster movies that struggle to balance human and non-human elements, this film seamlessly integrates the two. The movie uses its title not just as a description but as an overarching theme, exploring the concept of monsters in both literal and metaphorical senses. Alan Jonah, the human antagonist, mirrors the monstrous nature of King Ghidorah, while Dr. Emma Russell represents the duality of humanity. This thematic exploration adds significant depth to the film's narrative. The plot of Godzilla King of the Monsters also deserves praise for its well-crafted objectives and goals. Both the human and Titan characters have clear, interrelated goals that drive the story forward. This alignment creates a unified and engaging narrative. The final battle, where Godzilla fights Ghidorah and the human characters work to aid him, exemplifies this cohesive storytelling. Although the film's climax missed the opportunity to feature Jonah in the final showdown, the overall plot remains compelling and well executed. The film's greatest achievement lies in its ability to balance the human and Titan elements. By dividing the characters into clear sides of good and evil, it avoids the common pitfall of having too many conflicting themes. The protagonist side, representing balance, includes Godzilla and the human heroes striving for harmony. The antagonist side, led by Ghidorah and Jonah, seeks destruction. This clear delineation enhances the audience's emotional investment and makes the narrative more coherent and powerful. Despite its flaws, Godzilla King of the Monsters is a worthy watch. It successfully bridges the gap between human drama and monster mayhem, creating a film that is both visually stunning and narratively rich. The thematic depth, character development, and plot coherence make it a standout in the monster movie genre. It is a film that not only entertains, but also provokes thought about the nature of monsters, both giant and human. In conclusion, Godzilla King of the Monsters may not have been a box office smash, but it is a cinematic experience that delivers on multiple levels. It reminds us that monsters are not just creatures of myth and legend, but can also be found within ourselves. This film is a testament to the power of balance, showing that even in a world of titans, the human element is just as important. That's my opinion on Godzilla King of the Monsters. Do you agree with my thoughts? What are your thoughts on the film? Let me know in the comments. Please drop a like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. I ran away with my life, fast forward, never
turn back again. It's kind of funny that the more we pass time, the more we need to set them rewind. And 19 was the year I had to leave you, but now I'm seeing all the signs.